Hey, folks, I'm Ben, the Hot Dog Answer Man, and I am doing a special video called a cart critique for a fellow vendor, and I hope that it helps other vendors. But this vendor has been vending quite a while and has struggled at a location that has proven in the past to be good, or a similar location had. And he wondered, you know, what he could do different. And so he submitted some photos of his location, and I would like to share with everyone those photos and give my professional opinion on it. Just give an overall critique. It's not meant to slam him or anyone for that matter, but it's things that I noticed that could potentially make the difference between a crappy day and a busy day. So first, we will start with, let's see here. We'll start with the first photo, and everything looks good here. He's at a corner of a building, and you can see he must be right at the corner of it, and the door must be this way somewhere. And obviously the parking lot must be out here. He's got a tent set up, table set up. He's got a work area back in here, kind of keeps customers from coming back to him, which is smart. He's also put out some chips and stuff. Something I noticed immediately when I saw this picture is sometimes it is better to not put out any chips at all if you can't, basically, if you don't do enough. Too little of something makes it look shabby. And in my opinion, I would have at least 4 chip clip strips. You could probably get away with 3, but I would go with 4. And then it will look fuller. It will look more appealing. Have you ever been to a convenience store and walked in and seen you wanted a Hershey bar and they had 1 left or 2 left? I am not the person that will grab one. I'll pick a different snack because to me, it makes me think it's not fresh. They're down to their last little bit. And that's just the way my mind works. And I think others work the same. I have seen on my cart when I first started, I had 2 chip clips hanging from the umbrella. When I started adding them, and I have 6 usually now, that sales increased. People wanted chips. People would come up just for chips or cookies, and I'd hang the cookies there as well. He does have Famous Amos cookies, and that's fine. This, you wouldn't need to duplicate this, the cookies, if you're doing this. So you could be fine with 1 box of cookies. Once it got low, though, I would swap it out for a full box or an almost full box because it just doesn't look as good when there's 1 or 2 in there. I can't see from this side how many's in there. These are just the little things I noticed. One thing I like about this is he hung this fan way back here, hung it from his canopy. I think that is brilliant and will helps get rid of flies, and it keeps the area cool, and it sends off some of those beautiful smells off to the customers. So it works as advertising. I think that was genius, hanging it there. This is a closer up picture of his setup. Over here was that fan and stuff. This is his grill again, and this is his menu board. And if you notice, this is something that I didn't care for, is the menu board. Number one, I mean, this is okay. This is, you know, redneck ingenuity. It's strapped to the side, this marker board. That's okay. That probably wouldn't affect it. I probably wouldn't do this, but I would make this larger. I'd make this easier to read, even if it meant 2 boards or 3 boards. I would have no problem with a customer walking up and they would have no problem reading it. This could be a little small, and it's, even though it's handwritten, it's neatly done, but it's still so small, and he's got all the space on the sides that he could have used. I would say hot dog, $2, or all beef hot dog, $2. And he's got that in there, but it's so small, I would increase the size of that, and maybe get 2 boards. I don't know what this is. I assume this is some specialty dogs that he does that he's typed up and printed. Or no, in fact, I think that is his inspection where he got 100. And so that may be his inspection report. If you can afford to, it is better to put your inspection report in something nice. Even if you go buy one of those $1 frames at the Dollar Tree, where everything's a dollar, and set it in that, or put it in between one of those paper protectors or something. Make it look a little more like you're proud to display it. If it's your license or your report when they come inspect you. Either way, I'd make that stand out a little better. This, I would even if it's not small, you know, larger, even printing it up on pieces of paper and taping it up and having different ones, package one, package two, or meal one, meal two, you know, or meal deal or whatever it is. And you could put those around and it's going to be more appealing than this. Here's a picture of the front of the cart, and if you notice, he's got his bread out, which is normal. I would keep this other stuff, like fresh wipes, hand sanitizer, over on the table beside me. To the right of this was his little prep table. That's where I would keep that stuff, and he may do that already, but that's what I would do. The tongs and the bread and your gloves, those are fine there. That doesn't hurt a thing. It looks fine. It looks clean. You just don't want cleaning chemicals around it. If you're going to put this up, put it on top of the bread box or put it over where it's not as visible part of the food processing area. And that's another thing I would do. Here's another picture, and really can't find anything wrong with this. I do, even though, you know, mustard's fine to leave out and ketchup's fine to leave out in most cases. If you will put it in ice, it's more appealing. Even if you buy one of these little steel pans and put some ice in there and put your condiments in there, it will be more appealing to the customer. They'll go, this guy really cares about it being fresh and tasting right. It's, you know, people at home, I keep ketchup in the fridge and mustard as well. I know some people that keep it in their cabinet. I don't like it at room temp. So I see his mayonnaise is here. That should be in a cool vat. It may be. I can't see behind this. But that's the overall gist of it, is I would have these sitting just for the eye appeal and for the customers, you know, what they're going to see. The more little things you can do make a difference, whether they come back again. Something else is I wouldn't put my foil sheets on top of here. I'd move this to the side. Now, I do like how he's got his little thermometer ready to test. That shows somebody that's prepared and that is doing things following by the rules, and that's indicative of his 100 score that he got. Now, this is a picture from further off, okay? And you can see his whole setup. You can see the entrance to the store is down to the left of here. This is the wall that we saw earlier in the first picture. So this is the end of the store. Well, the problem with being here and not at the front door, right at the front door, and I can't really tell where the front door is, but I assume it's way over here, is that this, who knows what he's selling? And I know this particular vendor and what state he's in, and the state is not known for hot dog vendors. There's just not that many of them. Well, the problem with that is people may see this and think, oh, it's an employee thing. They're doing something for their employees. Or, oh, what is that? That is weird looking. That is cool. Or that's awesome. But they can't tell really what's going on. Like, is he selling hamburgers over there? Or is he selling barbecue? Or is he selling it all? I don't want to go ask. I see some stuff on a sign, but I can't tell what it says. I really don't know. And so what I would do here, one of the first things I noticed, the garbage can, I don't like it to be front and center and you know, the view. And this is the customer's view. This is the parking lot here would be out in front of here. And so you look up here and you see this, and I like the colorful umbrella. I like the tin. It looks clean and professional, okay? But the garbage can must go. He's already got a garbage can back here. For his personal use, I'd take this garbage can and move it over here, or move it down the sidewalk some, or move it even out here. I would have it away from my food and food prep area. He does have his cooler set up nicely, his extra gas tanks, his drinks, extra chips. But if you looked at this, it looks like one row of chips, and even if you got it a different angle and you saw two, it just doesn't look that appealing. So what I would do here is I'd spend the extra money. And a lot of vendors get to this point and they get discouraged because business isn't good. And they don't want to spend any more money. Okay. the problem is if you do your due diligence, you know what it's going to cost for the different things. And some of the things you need to do is marketing. And marketing is how you're set up. He's got these beautiful rugs. Okay. That makes it look clean. It's not just him standing on the concrete. It, even though this really doesn't matter, the rugs, it looks better. And I like that. But what I would do is put some signs out. Maybe I'd go get me a big, you know, a big supersized can of, you know, Coke sign. And I'd put it out by my thing. I'd grab me one of those old signs or something, or have one of these made and set it out. Well, now if you're walking up to this, can you tell what I'm doing? Well, absolutely. You can tell that I've got hot dogs and I've got drinks, and I've even put the price where it's legible. So that's something you could do. Something else you could do is get you a banner. Banners aren't that expensive, $20-$30, and you can get a nice banner. Banners on the Cheap is a good place to get cheap banners. It's called bannersonthecheap.com. And you hang a banner like this. Now look at that appeal. Let's say you're getting out of your car at this particular business and you see that. Well, you don't have any guessing what's he's got. I mean, there's no wondering. There's no maybe this is for the employees. No, because it's got a price. I wonder if he has drinks. Well, yes, of course he does. See the sign? That's the kind of thing. You could go a little less in your face and hang a banner something like this. And this kind of banner looks good. It shows a hot dog. It shows somebody eating it. It says hot dogs. And they could still read this from a distance because this is basically a 10-foot banner I just snagged off the web. You could go with, this is one of my favorites. When I'm out working, I'll put up my swooper flags, they're called. And they're on a pole and they go up, you know, above my tent. And I'll strap them to this leg of the tent and they sit there and swoop in the wind. And then you could grab you a banner still and still have room here. Okay. So you could put a banner like this for about $25, a swooper flag and pole for about $30, maybe this for 20 or 30, maybe get larger than life size cutout cardboard of Coke for $15-$20 on eBay or something. And you will end up, look at the appeal of this now. This looks good. If you set this here, it would hide that a little bit. You may could even leave your garbage can where it is and put the Coke thing in front of it. That would look good. You could take your, I'd still move the trash can. It's just me. There's lots of different ways you could do this. This feeling hungry gets the point across. It says hot dogs. It says hot dogs. It says drinks. And you could go with any number of signs. I just snagged some to see. I'd also have on my cart, you know, I'd put on the cart itself some signs. I'd get a vinyl decal. It's like $5 for Coca-Cola on eBay. Grab that decal, stick it on your cart. If you want it to say hot dogs, or if you want it to have your menu or your, I wouldn't do your menu because you change that from time to time, but you could do your business name. A lot of people will spend all their time using their business name on the side of their cart and it doesn't tell them what you do. I'd rather have my business name real small and what I'm doing real big. Pictures of a fresh hot dog on the side would look really cool here. Pictures of a steamy sausage on the front would look really cool here. So he's got a lot of things. These are little things you can do, but I can guarantee you, I'll guarantee it, that money back guarantee, that if you do this type of setup, now you've turned it into something. People will know what you're doing. You won't have to be hollering going, hey, you want a hot dog? Well, if they wanted one, they'd already be over there because they see that their hot dogs are $2 or whatever. I know it says a dollar here. You can get that made however you want. But I think that you could really make a difference. Now, take a look at this again with nothing, okay? And you can see the difference that made. Huge difference. It just doesn't have the same appeal. So this is what I would do if I was this customer, I would, or this vendor, I would change this so that it stood out. And I can bet you money that it would increase sales by at least 50% and possibly double sales. Just because you're now telling everybody what you did. He's got the right umbrella. It's already attracting people. This whole get up attracts people. They just don't have a clue. And a lot of them are too shy or just go, I don't want to go over there and ask what it is and then be told it's for some charity thing, that it's for the employees later today kind of deal. I don't like going up to things and asking if it doesn't look like I'm supposed to be there. And this from the outset looks like I'm not supposed to be there. There's nothing here saying, come on in. And you want to say, come on in. You want your location to scream, come on in, come get it. But you don't want it to be one of those deals where it's a secret. You don't want them to keep them guessing, going, what has he got over there? You want to, if you're serving pizza or you're serving fried chicken legs or you're serving, you know, roadkill, whatever you're serving, you want them to know what it is so that they don't have to come over and ask, because most people just simply won't do it. They're not going to come over and ask. Now, we know what a hot dog cart looks like. But when I first set up a hot dog cart in East Tennessee, no one knew. I had it on the side of the road. People were like, you know, blowing their horn and waving, but they had no clue what I was doing. Some of them pulled up, thought I had peanuts, because I too made this mistake. I had no signage of value that told them without them coming up to my little menu things that were, taped to my side of my cart. That's the deal. The other thing I want to reiterate is the fact that I'm not beating or bashing this particular vendor. I get a lot of these, or I get quite a few of these, and I usually critique them off to the side, but I felt it's better to start critiquing these like this so that you can see, so that it helps multiple people. And even me, I would have loved to have seen something like this when I got started. It would have saved me about 3 days of slower sales, because people driving by had no clue that I had hot dogs, sausages. So I would do this. I would take these things into effect, and you may already be vending and go, oh, I didn't think about, you know, a cardboard cutout of my hot dog or something like that. I've seen vendors with Marilyn Monroe stand-up cutouts and crazy stuff that works. But you want something that says hot dogs or says whatever you're doing so that you get that business without having to call out to them. I know vendors that call out, and sometimes that's a carny kind of atmosphere. And so I don't like it. I don't ever call out to people and go, hey, y'all hungry? I don't do that. So I would do the signs, let them do the speaking for you, and you'll find that your setup will go much better. This has been a fantastic job, this setup. I do nothing different other than those few things I showed you, and it will make all the difference in the world to this vendor and hopefully to you too. Please write me and let me know. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can catch videos there. I also do some exclusive videos over at learnhotdogs.com, and you can subscribe to that newsletter. I send out about one a week, sometimes one every 2 weeks. And check that out. Also, visit us over on the radio show. We do a radio show weekly over at Hot Dog Vendor Radio. You can search that on Google, or you can go to blogtalkradio.com/Ben's Carts and check that out there as well. We just started going live, and so you can watch it live on Ustream, Ben's Carts again, and you'll find us, and we'd love to have you. We'd love to have your opinions. If you have an idea for a show or would like me to discuss something or put something together in a video, I will send it over my way, and I'll look at it. Ben@learnhotdogs.com or Ben@Ben'sCarts.com. I thank you for watching. Hope you have a great day. I would appreciate it if you would comment below the video or and rate the video. I'd really appreciate that. It helps our ratings with Google and YouTube. So I appreciate it a bunch. Hope you have a wonderful day.